Hello everyone, we want to welcome you to our webinar today. We are excited to have Arno Marwan with us from 2Control, and Arno will be presenting on Strengthen Your Internal Control with Security Apps from 2Control. And before I pass it over to Arno, I just want to remind you that this webinar is being recorded, as well as all of our webinars, and it will be posted to our on-demand webinar library for you to review and share. And if you do have any questions, please feel free to type them into the questions box. At the end of our session, we will have a Q&A. So now I will pass it on over to Arno to kick off our presentation.
Well, thank you, Angie. I will turn on my webcam for a moment so people can see me. So hi people, hi everybody. Well, thank you for the introduction, and of course for the opportunity for us to demonstrate our solutions to your customers. Hello everyone. Thank you for joining this webinar. The title of the webinar is Strengthen Your Internal Control with Security Apps. And before I come to that, I want first to introduce myself, and after that I will turn off the camera because I want to show you a lot of things. My name is Arno Marwan. I will pronounce it in Dutch because I'm from Holland. I am the CEO and founder of 2Control, and I'm already working for almost 25 years as a certified information system auditor. We have to comply always to this global standards for professionals who work in the information systems, in particular for auditing, control, and security. So what did we do after a career of 10 years as an IS auditor within PwC? I worked, I founded 2Control in 2006. And with the mission I wanted to have there is to enhance the internal control of information security, especially in Microsoft Dynamics environments. And that's still the basis of 2Control. So we are now with 16 people and still growing, and all we are focused on IS auditing still. So we use this knowledge and experience to develop our security services and solutions for you, for Microsoft Dynamics. So what do we as IT auditors always found important? Well, simple, security and internal control. And what are our solutions then? Of course, about security and internal control. So that's where the title is back, Strengthen Your Internal Control with Security Apps. So remember that. I will now show you a few things on the slides. I will turn off my camera so the slides are better shown. But first, before I come to in, it's a little bit theory, history, something like, why are we doing it? So in short, this is our daily practice. We are confronted with the complexity of automation that's growing every day. From an internal control point of view, that leads to a lot of changes in working methods, how you use your systems, how the procedures are, and with that also the controls that you have in your organization. That again results in a failing system of internal control within a lot of companies. And besides that, more and more stakeholders require stronger controls. Stakeholders require you, not only stakeholders with contracts, but also stakeholders from legislation like the Sarbanes-Oxley. So these developments require solutions that makes it more easy for you to strengthen your internal control. So in short, examples that we experience in Dynamics are, do you have any insight in the quality of your authorizations? Most people don't. And from internal control point of view, that's of course a huge issue. Another issue is that within the standards, of Business Central, it's hardly impossible to implement a decent segregation of duties. So that's again a huge issue. Another thing is, if you want to set up authorizations on field level or on record level, or you want to have validations that strengthen the quality of your data, it's also almost impossible. So that's also a huge issue. So just this is a limited list of issues that you are facing and that leads to risks from an internal control point of view. So that's the reason that we as to control help a lot of customers. How do you deal with this topic? Do you recognize these challenges? I think so, otherwise you wouldn't subscribe. Have you ever looked to possibilities on field level or on validations? So I would say just keep listening, because we have solutions for all these issues. And to give you a little bit more confidence, our solutions is already available for more than 14 years. It's used by more than 400 companies already worldwide. So, and it's used by big companies and small companies. So a lot of companies do use our solutions. And to convince you, I will give a short demo of the solutions, so you can see how easily the security issues can be solved. And yeah, I want just to tell you, if there are developers around here, our apps also prevent a lot of customizations. So enough about the background, enough about to control and myself, enough about how many customers do we already have using, what is the software that we do deliver. In short, this is our slide, which I will tell you about what is our software suite about. Our software suite is aimed at three things. One thing is we want to simplify the management of authorizations. A lot of time this is experience is very complex. We want to monitor the quality of the authorizations. We offer you the opportunity to just monitor the quality in one click. And third thing that we want to offer is that you are able to refine the authorizations without a lot of customizations. So we want this software to support us that. And we provide these solutions for all versions of Dynamics NEV. For Business Central, we do that already from the versions from 3.6 until now. And it doesn't matter if your environment runs in the cloud, Business Central in the clouds, or on-premise. So it doesn't matter where it is. And our solutions are delivered as add-ons and apps in Business Central or connected to Business Central. Let's explain a little bit. You have Business Central standards from the box or implemented by your partner. What we do is we connect an authorization box to it. You have in the cloud or on-premise, we connect an authorization box to it to design, build, manage, monitor the authorizations. And it's a cloud solution that's running on Azure. For refining the authorizations, we can add there a field security app to it. The authorizations can then refine to field security on filter level or action level, whatever. And finally, to implement more abilities to validate the quality of the data, we add an app to it called Field Validations. And together we say you are in control with Dynamics. So in summary, when I come to that, look to the architecture of the, you have a Dynamics environment, NEV or Business Central, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter or it's in the cloud or on-premise. You can add the apps for field security and validation, and you can connect for all the management and monitoring to our solution, the box in running on Azure. So this is the suite. Before I will show you something in the demo, when we talk about authorizations, and I'm talking about IS auditors, information system auditors, we always think in a cycle, an authorization cycle. And this is, of course, comparable with how every project is handled. We have a cycle which starts with the design of authorizations. Assuming that you do not have any authorizations yet, or that you want to professionalize the management of the authorizations with our solutions, or you're starting with it, the cycle always starts with the design or the conversion of the design of the framework, the authorization framework that is used. And the framework that consists of permissions and security organization rules that are connected to the permission sets. And maybe the permission sets can be, of course, refined with our apps for field security or field validation. So, and if you have this framework, that's very important. This is the most important part of the really real good setup of the authorizations. And from experience, we always say that you have to create permission sets on task level. So, and when you look to your own environment, a lot of time you have about 80 or 220 tasks that are performed in Business Central. So then you probably will have 80 to 120 permission sets. Well, when you have set up the design, the authorization framework of your authorizations, and that's implemented, then you only have to manage the users that are coming in or coming out. When you have finished the design, you activate two procedures within your organization. The first one is, of course, the user management. And the second one is, how do you manage the changes in the framework? Because there can be changes in organization, changes in the software, so that have to be changed in the authorization framework. Both procedures are fully supported again with the authorization box. So the authorization cycle is still in the box always available. I will show it to you in a demo. So finally, you have a good design, you manage your new users, you manage your leaving users, the users that change functions. The last point is the most underexposed point in every implementation of authorizations. That is the monitoring. Keeping an eye on the quality of your authorizations. And the monitoring that we support then is focused on giving you insight in the data ownership, who is allowed to do what, but also on the segregation of duties. Do you not have breaches in the segregation of duties? Is someone able to and change the bank accounts together? So, and depending, of course, on the results, the cycle is completed and you can have changes that are necessary for design. So this is what I use for the demonstration. So first I want to explain what is in the authorization box. So I will pick up the slides for myself. When I have standard NAV, that's the first thing what I want to tell you. So about the design, what do we support about the design? When I have standard NEV, I always have to grant permission sets to a user, and I have to grant a lot of user setup, user authorization tables to the user. Both have to be done, and then the authorizations are set up. Sometimes you can extend it, of course, with our apps with it, but what we do in the authorization box, we support you to automate the express process. You define in the box an organization chart. You connect the permission sets to it. You connect some actions about the user setup tables to it. And then you have set up an authorization framework. After that, you can manage the users via authorization requests. You can put in an extra check in it that someone has to authorize it, and then the user automatically gets all that's needed for a function. Within the standard box, including conservation requests is supported. With an extension on it, you can use the templates and you can connect it to the functions. I will show it in a minute. But first, the monitoring, so the last cycle. So I have the design cycle that we do support, the management cycle that we do support, and now the monitoring cycle that we do support. And the monitoring cycle is very nice because within the standards, you can monitor always the data ownership and the segregation of duties, just like I mentioned. But the nice thing about it, if you extend it to continuous monitoring, the system will do it for you and the system will report directly if there is, for example, a breach in the segregation of duties. So coming to the demo. Hope everybody's still on. This is the authorization box. So I was talking about the cloud solution that was running on Azure that was connected to the Business Central. So this is the authorization box that is connected to Business Central. And here you see to which environment I'm connected at this moment. And within this environment, I can see the cycles that I showed you. The first cycle about the design is same as is everything in the authorization framework. If you extend that with an extra possibility for the user setup extensions, then it's extended with the Management Pro functionality in it. If you finish the design, then you only use the user management, and that is used for users that coming in or out the organization. And if you want to monitor the quality, you will go to the monitoring. Well, first I'd like to show you the last thing. That is nice, of course, because if you look to the quality of your authorizations, then you can think about how to go further. And if you look to the quality of the authorizations, it's always very detailed. You have a lot of details. There are 5,000 objects or something or more. You have a matrix with 500 permission sets, so that makes it very complex to audit it. When you use our system, you just ask questions to the system. For example, who has the user permissions, or who can check inventory balances, or who can prepare payment proposals? Just questions. And if you ask questions to the system will answer you, and the system will answer you on different levels. So first I get an example with some questions that we say that have a high impact. And then we have two questions that is a lot of time asked. Who can prepare payments within the system? And you can also ask who can change vendor bank accounts. Well, these questions are always pre-filled by us, and it's also pre-filled by us how these questions can be answered. But you have the ability to change all the questions, to change all the way the questions has to be answered, or to add a lot of questions or delete questions, whatever you want. And within each question, we analyze the data ownership, but we also analyze the segregation of duties. And of course, this is a nice example because we don't wants to have people to be able to prepare the payment proposals and to have people that are able to change the vendor bank accounts. So when I open this question, my system will show me which users, which permission sets, which roles are able to prepare payment proposals. So here you can see who are able. Just focusing only for this demo on the users. And I can see here that a lot of test users are able. And the test users, we gave them some names like Hannah, she is external accountant, and Edward, etc. And per user, per answer, I can start a review process. And the nice thing is the system decides already what have to be reviewed or what not have to be reviewed. If, for example, there was a user here who was able to prepare payments and she or he was also allowed to do that from her function, then the system would set here agreed according to the setup. But here there's no one agreed according to the setup. So on every review, I can say I agree, I do not agree, I want to something to do. So then you can prove to your auditors or other stakeholders that you also keep track on the quality of your authorizations. But the nice thing here is also here the data ownership is shown. But what I also is shown now is the conflicting permissions. And here is saying that who can prepare payment proposals, but here is also saying that who can prepare the bank accounts because there's a conflict in permission. And that's also pre-set up by us, but you can also change all those setups for the conflicts that you want to check. And here I can see that Edward, the manager, is able to change the vendor bank accounts and to prepare payment proposals. And then I can say, I disagree because of, or something have to be done. So things like that. So this is very nice solution that you see at one click, the quality of your authorizations. And what I mentioned already, when you have the ability to subscribe it for continuous monitoring, you see here also the possibility that you can subscribe to that. So if I subscribe here for this question, and I say I always want to have insight in changes in the answers in the questions, then I can put in here my email, and the system will give me a notification directly when there is, for example, a new conflict. So by that, I don't even have to open the tool. The system will inform me. So by that, you have continuous monitoring and you have always insight in the quality of your authorizations. So that gives you some insight in this part of the cycle. Now I will start to this side. I showed you already that the authorization framework is about it. And I will tell you, when you implement your authorizations or when you convert your existing authorizations to this environment, you have always to follow three steps. The first step is, of course, you have to have a good set of permissions. That's what I mentioned in the beginning. So from here, you can monitor all your permissions that are in the system. And what we mentioned, it's best to have systems permission sets on a task basis. If you do not have the correct permission sets, then you can record, of course, new permission sets into Business Central directly with the functions of Business Central for that, or you can use our recording functionality to record permissions. And that's the first step. So if you have correct permissions, then that's the first step. The second step is to identify how you want those permissions assigned to the users, because do never set up authorizations directly to users, but assign them via organization walls, via functions. So what we offer is you the possibility to set up an organization chart here with departments and functions, and then offer you the possibility to assign to the roles here the correct permission sets. And if you have extended with the Pro module, you can also connect to the same roles all actions that have to be done for all the user setup tables. So here I connect to all the permission sets that have to be granted to a user, a purchase employee. So if someone comes in and that user is a purchase employee, that user automatically gets these permission sets. For this step, it's very difficult, of course, because now I decided how the organization chart should look like. But if I have to do every time by hand go in here and connect all the permission sets, and during a project or a conversion, there's a lot of work, we created some extra opportunity to export and import this structure via Excel. So if I put this, if I export the structure to Excel, then I get an overview of two matrices. One matrix with the permission sets per organization role, and another matrix with the users per organization role. So that's my third step. Because I can put this in Excel, I get an overview, I can change everything in Excel, I can put crosses in it, then I import in Excel again, and then it's also imported. And the nice thing is, it imports it from Excel, but it checks all the business rules that have to be there. So even if you are not allowed to change the crosses between the permission sets and the organization roles, you will not be allowed to import this, for example. So this is the basis of your authorization framework. So coming back to this cycle, to the upper part, I come back later to field security and field validation. Then we are finished. Everybody has the correct function. I did also import the matrix of the users per organization role. But then some changes have to be there. And that's the problem always. In a project, the organization framework is set up correct. Everybody agrees. Everybody is happy. And something changes. And that user doesn't test anything or whatever. It does change because someone says it has to change. That's what we want to avoid. So that is the one of the processes that I said was starting after finishing the authorization framework. And for that, we introduced a 4I principle in the whole system. So if you want, you can put a 4I principle on every change that is done in the system. That is one of the measures that we took. The other measure that we took is that we log all the changes that are done in the system. So if I change something in the framework, it is locked in a change log. So by that, we support the change management process, because there you always have insight what is changed, and it is as so you have the possibility to say, okay, a change is only allowed after approval about by someone else. So that is the first process that is started when I finished the design. And the second process that is started when I finished the design is, of course, the user management for new hires, leaving employees, etc. And that is supported by the user management here. And it's supported by a very easy process. All the changes are requests. So just I have a request. I have a request for a new user, an existing user. It doesn't matter. And within each request, it's on user level. And for example, I have a request for George, and George is already a user, and he is a warehouse employee. I can say, okay, I want George to help, for example, the manager, and he has to have some extra permissions, but only for today up till the end of the week. So you will not forget to remove it. And that is the standard, most standard that. If you grant someone temporary permissions, those temporary permissions are always the final permissions, the definite permissions. I can say to which company here, for example, it's only for the Belgium company, and I can save and close. And also here, there is a 4I principle, and it set it up already. I cannot process the request now directly, but I have to send an approval for this change. And when I send this approval, the approver who is set up in the system gets an email. It gets an email with the question that I did change and did put in a new authorization request. And do you agree or not? And the user can open and see, okay, there's a new authorization request because for these dates, this user gets the warehouse manager permissions. So, and then I can approve or decline. So by that, I support the user management. And the nice thing also is that always on user level, I give an overview that for later on, I can see for these days, this user was also temporary the manager role. So you see all the history. So that's also support again, the auditability. So back to the cycle, then the cycle is around because I know what's the quality. I can change things. I do know how to set up very fast the design of the authorizations, and I can easily manage the users. So that makes it more easy to manage, monitor the all authorizations and the setup of it. Yes. So then I go to the field security and the field validation part. Within NEV, if you want someone to be allowed to change only one or two fields on, for example, the item card, then you have to change some the codes because it's not possible to set it up within NEV or Business Central standards. You have all the fields within an object or no fields, and there's nothing in between. We created a field security app that works without any modification. So it's a field, it's an app that's really an extension. Of course, in Business Central, it's also an extension, but in NEV, it's also an extension because it doesn't change any existing object. And what do we extend? We extend the functionality of a permission set because normally standard, you can grant permissions to objects within permission sets. But with our module, you can also grant fields, filters, and actions to a permission set. What do we mean by that? Well, fields, it's, I think you understand. With filters, you can think about that you are only allowed to change the local customers and not the foreign customers. And with actions, you can think about the actions that are the buttons on the pages. You are not allowed to use one or two buttons within the. So then you, for example, you are not allowed to use the button approve invoice, things like that. The last one is only available in Business Central and not NEV. This is the first thing that we add with the field security app. And then we have the field validation app. And the field validation app also extends the standard possibilities. Also possible to connect it to the permission sets, but also without connecting it to the permission sets. And then you add a lot of field validation possibilities. And within that, you can say, okay, I want the fields to be mandatory. Think about the posting groups in an item or a customer or an vendor. I want to add filters. So I'm only allowed to put in values that is within a filter. Or I want to check on length of a field. But I can also check with related other fields, a related field within the record or a related field within another record. Think about things like I want that the description of an item in a purchase order or a sales order, let's say a sales order, is always equal to the description of the item in the item card. Otherwise, you are able to sell an item with a complete different description. That are things that you can't restrict normally within NEV or Business Central. So you can do a lot of checks. Well, I can talk a long time about it, but I can bet. So for that, I will start a demo in Business Central. And I have to refresh this. So this is for the NEV users. This is Business Central, so the newest version of NEV, let's say it like that. When I open some screens, you will see that it looks a lot of the same. So when I show you the field security first, Then I go to, for this example, to items. So I'll look up for the item lists. And when I open this, if it wants to work with me, yes, I want to show you that I'm not allowed to change anything on a bicycle field, for example. So if I try to change the description here, it looks like I'm able to change it. But as soon as I leave the cart, it will do a check for me. And the check is saying now that I do not have permission to change the description because of a filter. And the filter is mentioning that I'm only allowed to change the raw materials of the inventory posting groups. And currently I'm trying to change a finished product. So it's saying you are not allowed to change a finished product. So I have only the possibility to reverse this change. So let's go to a raw material. Let's check for, I found a raw material. And then I try to change the description again. So I will try to change it again. I will leave the records. And it gives me again an error message. But the error message is now not about a filter because I was able to change the raw materials, but I'm not allowed to change this field on the raw materials. It's saying, no, you're not allowed to change the description because of the field security settings. And why? Because I did set up now a situation that I have the permission of a purchaser, and the purchaser was only allowed to change purchase fields. So fields like item number of a vendor, or the vendor the vendor number, or the purchase unit of measure. So if I change now here, and someone is saying there have to be something behind, and I try to save it now, I will be able to do that. So there was no problem. So I did create now a matrix on this object item because I'm only allowed to change some purchase fields. I did set up vendor item, this purchase fields, but only for raw materials. Well, let's show me how I did do it, because that was is a very easy way to extend the possibility of the permission set, because I did set up it via permission set. So I go to the field security setup, and I did create here a check and control for an item. And in this control, I only said I want to have a control on table 27. Table 27 is the item table. And this control is set up with default no field editable except for these fields. And this control is connected to a permission set for the purchaser, and for this demo also to a super user. So by this, I am granted the super role in this environment, and by having the super permission set, I am not allowed, or I'm only allowed to change these vendor fields on an item. And this setup can be done on every table, if it's standard NEV or it's extension or doesn't matter. And the nice thing is you can set it up in two ways. You can say all no fields are editable except, or for according to this example, all the fields are editable, but not a description. But you can initially fill the description. So I just talked about the description example, that you're not allowed to change it. Here you can set up, you are not allowed to change the description, but you are allowed to initially fill it from zero to a value, but not allowed to change it. So things like that you can set up in this environment. This was the way that it is set up the field security, but I was only allowed to change raw materials. So if I go to the filter security list, and there is a setup on the item, it is set up in a similar way, table 27, but now not with fields, but with filters. And I did just only create a filter on a field within the table, But I can also create a field related to that table. So for example, if I want to have the same check that I'm only allowed to change prices of raw materials, I can here add the table, the price table, and I can put in a relation to the inventory posting group of the item and can say, okay, that is raw material and I'm only allowed to change raw materials. And again, this is assigned to, again, a permission set, and by that I extended the functionality of the permission set. So that is very easy to extend the functionality of security, the security functionality with NEV. So that is about the filter security and the field security, and you can also use the same thing for action security. And in the final, I will show you the field validation, because for this part I'm only thinking about restricting users to do something, but I also can restrict users to save something without mandatory fields or things like that. So if I go to validation, the field validation lists, I've a lot of examples. But the first example is about a customer. And here I've a very lot of functionality that I can put in about a lot of controls that can be done on validation level. I did put some examples here, but again, I started with the table. So here I want to add a lot of controls on the customer table. And I can say, if there's something wrong about the controls I define here below, you have to give me a warning or you give me an error. A warning is sometimes better, because then you can say, for this example, if I ignore the warning, so the action after the warning is that I block, for example, all the field, I put the field blocked to all. So by that, I can still save the field, the records, but not use the records. And here I did set up that I only do the check for this check below only if the record is not blocked. And I can also say, when I create a new record, I want to put in some values in it. And the nice thing is, I can also say, I want to check here the default dimensions. And this is something very nice, because within any standard you can set up, there are some, for example, for customers, there are mandatory dimensions that always have to be filled in. Almost all my customers do have this setup. But Business Central only checks this mandatory during posting and not during setup of the customer. Just by putting here the table ID 18 and set here the validation default dimension to on, the system checks for you during creation of the system the default dimension settings. Well, and further on, you can do a lot of checks. You can, of course, check on mandatory. You can set the filters. For example, I'm only allowed to put in US customers. I'm only allowed to put in credit limits between 1 and 1,000. I'm only to put in phone numbers with 10 minimum or maximum of 10 figures. And I can do it also to related records. So I have only to put in that. I, for example, I want to have that customers are only can only be unblocked if there is a ship one, at least one ship two address put in. Well, you can think about a lot of checks that can be done. The last one I created is about related fields. I don't know anymore what that was. You can put in a lot of fields. There's a new feature coming, I think, in the one of the coming weeks. And then you can say, you can put in a lot of checks, for example, that there have to be a capital, or a lot of checks you can think about, or that the postcodes always have to be some form, or things like that. So with this, you have a lot of field validation functionality and possibilities. And the nice thing is, again, that if I put here show more, that you can say, okay, it's applicable for all the companies in my environment, and it's only one company, or it's applicable for a limited set of users via, again, the permission sets, because we never grant directly checks to users. We always say we do it via permission sets. And why? Because it doesn't extend the job you have to do during users coming in or leaving the organization. So, in summary, the add-ons extends the permission sets with fields, filters, and actions, and the add-on or the app extends the possibilities to add a lot of checks on fields and validate on mandatory filters, etc. And by that, you can add functionality that enhances your security. So that's what we offer you. And what we always say, it's always around the cycle, the authorization cycle. So you have a good design of your framework. You extend the design with field security possibilities, filters, actions, validations. And if that's okay, you make sure the change management on it is okay. Then you have a good procedure and tools that support your change, your user management. And you always have insight in the quality of your authorizations. So most solutions speaks for themselves. A lot of things I showed you, I think a lot of users can already use it without any help. But we always advise clients to attend at least one day training if you are going to use these solutions. So that's what I have to tell you, and I wanted to show you, and I want to thank Angie for that she showed me. And if you are not convinced yet that these solutions can strengthen your internal control with our solutions, ask our over 400 customers worldwide that are using it already. And if you're not convinced, we offer these solutions already for 14 years. And we did grow always with all versions of Navision, Dynamics NAV, Dynamics Business Central. We started with Navision version 3.6. So, but for me, it's there's a possibility now for questions. But if there are no questions, I want to say you already join the community of these solutions of our already worldwide active customers, and try to strengthen your internal control also with the security apps. And I want to thank you already now for all your attention, but you have still the possibility, of course, to ask questions. So if there are questions, please ask them now, and otherwise we will stop the presentation. I'm sorry, someone that put in this slide about the costs. So I will leave it here so you can see what the costs are for the solutions. I did not know that this slide was coming. For here, thank you for your attention. And if there are no questions, then we will stop the presentation. Angie, do you have any questions?
Thank you, Arno. Yes, we do have a couple that came through. If anybody has any additional ones, please feel free to type those in and we will get those addressed. The first one is, which versions of NAV are available? I have an older version and I just want to make sure it's available for me to use.
Yeah, if you look, I just mentioned that we are already supporting the solutions from Navision 3.6. Our upgrades and new features, we always support a few versions back, but we are our solutions are available from already still Navision 3.6 up till now. And that's, I think, what we get a lot of compliments always from customers, that's because we always go with the new versions of Navision, and it doesn't cost the customer any conversion or something like that. So I hope, yeah, that I can help, we can help you with an older version also.
Okay, great. Thank you. Yeah. And is it possible to upgrade from Nav to Business Central?
Yes, yeah, that's a question that a lot of customers ask, because yeah, a lot of customers are now pushed, of course, to the Business Central environment, and that's a lot of time a re-implementation of a lot of environments. Yeah, this is because Microsoft did choose a complete different way of programming and supporting those environments. What we did do is we had the add-ons within NEV, and we have apps, of course, in Business Central. The functionality, the way of working are almost similar. So when we have customers now, you can upgrade with the same discounts that Microsoft offers you, and the setup is we support you with a standard setup conversion tool. So you don't have to do anything new on the setup. So if you did set up 10 or 20 security field security settings, you can convert it automatically. So yeah, I think the answer is yes. And we did also support it in the same way as Microsoft did support it. So you get by head a 40% discount on the subscription if you go, if you already have a license on the add-ons, and if you then go to the apps of Business Central.
Okay, great. Thank you, Arno.
Okay.
I believe those are the only questions that have come through. If anybody does have any further questions and you would like to discuss them with Arno, please feel free to contact Arno. Do you have your information up?
Yes. But I think otherwise they have to contact you, and you can forward them to us.
Yes, most certainly.
Otherwise they can contact us on our website. It is tocontrol, like this described here. And you put info at tocontrol, and then the questions also come to us.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah.
And also you can contact your account manager here at Innovia Consulting, and we can collaborate and get your questions answered. So I just want to thank everyone for attending today. And if you're watching on demand, thank you for joining us. Thank you again, Arno, for presenting.
Yeah, you're thanking for the opportunity. And everybody, thank you for your attention.
And we do have more webinars coming up. Tomorrow we have Generics Group presenting on new implementation methodologies for a remote world. And next Tuesday, we have Tracy Bregetzker from Innovia Consulting, and Tracy will be presenting on easily send documents electronically to customers with Business Central Nav. So check out our website for more of our upcoming events, and that's innovia.com/events. Have you heard our podcast yet? It's called the Innovia Conversation, and we just want to encourage you to listen to our selection that our hosts, Steve Waltz and Jeff Pergolsky, have provided to us. And you can find out about all the different podcast platforms to listen to on our podcast page. And that's innovia.com/podcast. So check out our podcast selection and subscribe so you'll be notified when those new episodes air. And fall is nearing, and that means conference time in our environment. Innovia Consulting is proud to be a premier sponsor for Dynamics Con. This is a new virtual conference that is coming up next week, September 9th and 10th. Did I mention that it's free to attend? Innovia is also a premier sponsor for Community Summit, which is also a virtual event coming up October 7th through the 9th. Summit is the annual gathering of all Nav and Business Central users and supporters. And both of these events are full of great sessions to help you develop leadership skills, improve your Nav BC skills, and so much more. So check out our conference page, and that's innovia.com/conferences for more details on these conferences and how you can save money on your Summit registration. All right, well, we thank you again for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you soon on another Innovia webinar.